Un poquito demasiado, teniendo en cuenta que estaba programado para las 6 este taller, pero va a merecer la pena en todo caso. Bueno, pues tal como acabamos de anunciar ahí fuera, el autor de un sistema operativo que está siendo cada vez más conocido, un sistema operativo para máquinas antiguas, para máquinas de 8 bits, con toda la rotura de límites que ello conlleva, como hemos comentado anteriormente, está aquí. Se trata de John Mika, más conocido como Prodatron. Ha desarrollado este sistema operativo para máquinas CPC y recientemente se acaba de migrar para máquinas MSX, haciendo incluso compatibles los binarios, las aplicaciones, los ejecutables para ambas plataformas. Y bueno, sin más, va a presentar la última versión, la versión 1.1, en eso la encontrará aquí para nosotros. Y en primer lugar, agradecer, thank you to John Mika for his presence here and for this workshop, as for the conference he was in yesterday. Y sin más, voy a hacer la palabra a John, que es el verdadero protagonista. Una pregunta, ¿el taller puede ser hecho en inglés o en inglés con traducción a español? ¿Qué se prefiere entre el público ahora mismo? A ver, aquí hay alguien que prefiera que se traduzca en español. Everybody speak English? A ese dice que no, pero no levanta la mano. Bueno, entonces, the workshop is going to be held in English, so no need for translation. All for you, Jörn.
Okay, yeah, thanks for coming. I'm Prodatron. I want to present you Zimbus today. Yeah, so unfortunately, I don't speak Spanish, so I have to talk in English, but when it's okay for you and Inaki don't need to translate, then we can do it like this. Okay, Zimbus is an operating system for Z80-based computers like the Amstrad CPC and the MSX. So for these two models, there's a version available. But today I will only show it on the CPC because yeah, this emulator is better to use. Okay, so I will start it now. So the goal was to make an operating system which is very similar to Windows. So it has a graphical user interface, preemptive multitasking. It can access hard disks up to 128 gigabytes. Yeah, and some other features. So to start with the multitasking, I will just open the task manager. Here you can see the real CPU usage. So it's not a fake. It's able to measure it. sorry. So okay. Now let's see what we have here on my hard disk. This is Sim Commander. It's an application for file matching, so you can surf through your. I think you know Norton Commander. It's just a clone of Norton Commander. These are some graphics. I'm now able to double click a graphic, and then because of the file association, the view will be started and shows the selected graphic. So we can start a slideshow now. It can run in the background. Another application is ZimAmp. It's a player for music. So okay, I have no sound here, but I think that's better so. And I have a complete playlist editor. Okay, so now we have already 5 different windows open. As you can see, we have now a little bit more CPU usage. So let's close. So what else can we do? Maybe we can open the control panel. I have a little problems with the mouse. typical effect. Okay. Ah, I'm afraid that he will start it several times. Okay, so in the control panel we can configure the complete system. Like in this symbol you have. Okay, the problem is I started the control panel several times, so now we have a little bit heavy system usage. So I pressed to open on the control panel, now I have four different control panels open. That was too much for our poor CPC. I will start again. So in the control panel we can configure everything like the like a screensaver. Like the file associations. So we have here several extensions, so they are all applied to a special application. Because of this it's possible just to call a file and the operating system knows which program must be started. So like I know it will open a video file. So this is the so-called sim shell. I can also use it in full screen mode. But of course in window mode it's much more interesting, but I will start in full screen mode the video, so that means the desktop, which runs in the background, is still active. So when I go back to the desktop, I have now the video player open and can start now this video. So while he shows the video, I can maybe now play Minesweeper. So the windows are now overlapping, which is a little bit more CPU, so which use a little bit more CPU time, so everything's a little bit slower now. But in most cases it's still running. Flip, flip. So what else can we show? Okay, I think I presented now most of the applications. Okay, so Zimos exists since the first release exists since the beginning of this year. So there's still much to do for programming applications and for porting Zimos to other operating systems, to other computers like the MSX, or it's also possible to port it to the SAMP4P and to the Enterprise. And well, the goal is of course to have at the end a complete desktop PC in a small 8-bit machine. So Zimos, you can start Zimos on an unexpanded MSX2 or CPC6128. But it's of course it's better when you have memory expansions or hard disks or whatever. Okay, I think that was a small overview. So we could now come to the workshop. Maybe you have some questions or whatever.
Anybody that wants to ask Prodatron something about the operating system, maybe about the development, maybe about the future, the possibilities or something like this? Could you come here, please?
I'd like to know how long it has taken you, how long you've been developing on this, how well you know the architecture on this. I mean, I imagine that it's a lot of work to get to know a machine like this and then be able to start building something on top of it.
Well, okay, first I also thought that you should have much knowledge about the machine or that it takes a long time. Okay, first to your first question, the complete working time was 1.5 years. So, I worked longer on it, but took some breaks. So, but the effective time was 1.5 years. Now I started with the MSX ports. I didn't know anything about the MSX, but it took only two weeks to know everything about the system, so that you can start working on such a project. So it's not as bad as I thought before. So I'm looking forward to support other machines like the Sam Coupé, and I hope I also will not need so much time to come into this new hardware.
Mm-hmm. More questions? More questions?
Hi. I just want to know if the symbols can run from a diskette or it needs a set of special ROMs to be attached to the machine in order to run.
Oh, so you don't need the ROM. You can also start it from disk. I just used the ROM version because it booted very fast, but you can also boot it from disk. So it's not a problem.
Another question? I have a question. I don't know if could it be possible to show SimStudio, the integrated development environment for Windows,
okay.
For develop SimBoss application using a Windows environment.
Okay, yes, I can. So SimStudio is a Windows-based application with which you can develop SimBoss application. So you develop it on a PC, and then you compile it also there, and can run the finished application then on the CPC. So this is SimStudio. You have a form editor. It's a little bit like Visual Basic, Visual Studio. So you can place all the different controls here. Then you have a code editor, which is which supports also syntax highlighting and so on. Then you have a video converter, which is not activated. The problem is that this program is still under development, so it's not very easy to demonstrate it. So the most interesting thing is the form editor, I think. Yes, and this is the compiler, which then after the second pass, so it writes the finished application in a disk image, which you can then start in the emulator. So you can develop everything on a PC, which is of course much easier and much faster than to do it on the real machine.
Question? Hi, you compiled these applications or environment with SimStudio for MSX or CPC, or it's differently compiled?
No, so SimBoss is cross-platform able, so that means that every application which runs on the CPC also runs on the MSX. So you don't need to compile it two times, you only need to compile it one time, and then the same binary runs on both machines without any modifications.
For different machines, no?
Yeah, so, currently there are only two machines, but on both machines, so like when you have this application as a binary, the same, you can put it on a disk, you can put this disk in an MSX, start it, and you can put this disk in a CPC and start it, and then runs on both machines.
Okay, thanks.
does it support networking or it will support in the future?
What?
Networking. If this is support networking or it will be in the future?
The future.
Networking.
Ah, networking. Ah, yes. So yesterday we had a conference here with Nestor who developed Dumas, and so he's currently developing an Ethernet interface for the MSX, and of course the goal is to have Ethernet, so to have TCP/IP support in ZIMOS 2. So and then this is only a preview, but maybe in the future we then have a client, a chat client. So I have a small view here. So this is an application called ZimChat, which is of course only in beta stadium. And I hope when the hardware is available, then we can also support it in ZimBOS.
To code applications, what language do you use? It's assembler in SimStudio, or it's your own language?
You can code it in BASIC or in assembler.
BASIC.
So yes, so ZimBASIC is a little bit like Visual Basic. So it's quite easy to develop applications in BASIC, but on the other side they will be a little bit bigger than if you develop them in assembler.
Because all these applications that I using, you have code in assembler.
Yes. So currently everything is in assembler, but if you want, you can also use BASIC.
Okay.
Which file system does Amstar use?
ZIMBA supports Amstar, that's the file system of the CPC, CPM, and FAT, all the three FAT file systems, so FAT12, FAT16, and FAT32. So with FAT12 you can read DOS disks, and with FAT32 you can access hard disks with a maximum of 128 gigabytes. So that's really enough.
Another question? Yeah.
I see that you have attached to your computer some hardware things. Have you made those too, or are they available?
Yeah, so this is another project. Okay, it's also connected with ZimBOS. It's the main feature of this hardware is a hard disk interface, the IDE interface. So with this hardware.
Made the hardware for it?
No, I'm not responsible for the hardware. So that's another project from another guy. So I'm only for the software.
Another question? I want to know, Prodatron, have you think about port some other applications you have developed for the CPC, as the text processor or the tracker, to ZimBOS?
Oh yes, I would like to make an Excel clone, maybe a Word clone, but I don't know. And of course, what I want to do is a web browser. So I don't know if it will be possible to display graphics, but I want to display websites with tables and text formatting and all these things, so that you have a comp. So at the end, I will be able to chat on my CPC, to surf on it, and to do other nice things.
So I'd like to know which was the hardest part when you.
One of the hardest part was the whole disk system. So FATs, the support of FATs. 32 of such big devices. Yeah, that was the hardest part because it's you only have to do with numbers and hex dumps and very boring work. So, yeah, not so funny.
Another question for Prodatron. Okay, there is no more questions. There is one more question, sorry. Come here, come here, come here, come here.
¿Hay posibilidad de hacerlo para Spectrum o lo viste que no valía para Spectrum?
Is there any possibility to port symbols to a Spectrum, or have you seen that Spectrum is not a good platform for such an operating system?
Unfortunately, so Simbus requires special bank switching possibilities. So the Z80 CPU can only access 64 kilobytes. So you need additional hardware bank switching features with which you can access more memory, because 64 kilobytes is not enough for Simbus. The problem with the Spectrum is that only the +3 supports the extended memory in a way so that Simbus can use it. So unfortunately, it would only be possible for the +3. So the question is if it really makes sense.
El problema con un Spectrum es que tan solo es capaz de acceder a 64K de memoria, y el único caso del Spectrum que él conoce que es capaz de acceder a varios bancos de memoria, memoria extendida, se trata del +3. Por lo tanto, quizás fuera posible hacerlo con el +3, pero sería el único Spectrum que sería capaz de soportar Simbus. We have another question. I see that Simbus is generating a lot of questions. That's great.
It's not really a question, it's like another showing, another demo of the Simbus. Can you log your session?
I could log my system in the past. Currently, I wrote this. Wait, I have this.
Because I saw a video a time ago in a party.
Ah, yes.
With another computer with an MP3 player. I can remember the name, but I saw your computer locked with Simbus and the
lock. Yeah, I think you know you mean this. Do you mean this dialogues? I think you mean something like this.
Yes, and enter password and...
Yeah, so this module is currently not activated because I wanted to save some memory and decided to separate this module in an extended one, which you can load if you want, so it's... This one, yeah. Okay, so, but I removed it because of memory problems. So it's so I don't want the core system to be too big, because then small systems can't run it.
No questions? Are you looking Prodatron for any help from the development community, from CPC or another platforms?
Well, of course, I would be glad if someone wants to develop some applications for Simbus. Especially in the MSX community, I had much help for the much support when I was developing the MSX version. This help is really appreciated, and but it would also be nice if someone do some applications. Of course, I'm happy to help him, and yeah, it would. So the nice thing of applications developing applications for Simbus is that then it will already run on two different computer systems. So you have a big number of users.
Okay, any other question for Prodatron?
Last one.
In symbols for MSX, to will connect to internet by Ethernet.
By Ethernet?
What? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes, I
will be connected by yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so I when Dumas is available, I think it will be the hardware of the choice. I don't know if there's already other hardware available which you can go in the internet
or network or
yeah. Yeah, so I'm quite new on the MSX, so I don't know if so. but yeah, well Dumas or something else.
Okay.
Okay, any last question? Okay, so then we have to give thanks to Prodatron for his productions and also for to be so kind to be here from Germany. He wanted to know Euskal Encounter and Retro Euskal. We are very happy to have Prodatron here. And well, I think that this could be it's not the beginning, of course, it's just a continuation, but I think it could be a good beginning to user for several 8-bit old vintage platforms to become together developing the same applications, as Prodatron has told to us that it could be possible now with CPC and MSX. And who knows, maybe in the future for some other platforms. Nothing more. Thank you very much for the public, and especially thank you very much for Prodatron for to hear and for symbols, of course. Thank you very much to everyone.
Yeah. Thank you for coming. Muchas gracias. It was a pleasure to be here.
I want that video.
Huh?
I want that video.
You want the video?
NEPA format. Well, no, CBC is better. It's
yeah,
nicer.
I think it's better, yes. it's.
No sé, pues se venía aquí para recoger la cámara. Cuidado, tú que llevas el power.
No, los 50 hercios.
Ya que la memoria no se lo quita porque no.